day you hate. The little black boy with no swag who wore his shoes without no lace. But now I'm getting P and getting famous. So you can keep your feet.
Western Railroad, the Jews run the country, you know?
Hello there.
Oh, dear.
What the hell are you doing?
Awful rough to me. Why can't all men be like you?
You take care, lady. There might not be anyone around next time. Yeah!
Who did?
He's missing. He's only a youngster. My boy is missing.
Where? Who took him?
Them people in the hills. Them hills near Hanging Rock. They took him.
Can't the police force help you?
Oh, they can't even help themselves. Please, sir. My son is missing. I need your help.
If I find him, I'll bring him back to you.
I don't have a clue. All right, but it's got to be something to do with that government boy.
We'll talk to him, find out what he knows.
He fucking is. Where is she, Marston?
Who?
Who? My daughter, you fucking scum. Where's Bonnie?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since after the fire. Why?
Why? Because she hadn't been seen since yesterday afternoon. You know, I don't think I can cope. If I lose another child...
Now, Drew, nobody's lost anything yet. I'm sure she's fine.
Oh, Mr. Marshall! Mr. Marshall! Come out, come out, wherever you are!
Who the hell's that?
Hey, buddy! That'd be your next fucking mayor.
Even better! Good day, Mr. McFarlane!
Get down from that horse, boy, or I'll shoot.
I wouldn't recommend that, mister. Not if Drew McFarlane wants to see his bony back in one piece. Hey, Mr. McFarlane! This is a nice girl you got there.
Get down from there!
You know, part of me's got to thinking I should just marry her myself. Give her a baby and that.
What do you want?
That's better. I want Norman Deke. I want him set free. Then you'll get your daughter back, mister.
We don't do deals with outlaws, boy.
Yeah, you do. Let's not waste each other's time pretending otherwise. Oh, government themselves ain't much more than a bunch of crooks. This is the land of opportunity, mister. And I'm giving you the opportunity to get your daughter back before 15 friends of mine take out all their anger and their loneliness on her.
Where the hell is she?
Where is she, boy?
Bring Deke up to Tumbleweed in a couple hours. And don't get no funny ideas, or I will slit that whore's throat myself. You boys have a pleasant afternoon. Yeah!
What do we do?
We do as he says. You and me, Marshal. Mr. McFarland, I'll get you your daughter back. I owe her that.
Please do.
I'll teach you some respect for the law. Hurry up, boy. Let's go. Quick as you can, deputy. Make sure he's tied on good.
Stay with me, Marston.
I won't let anything happen to her, sir.
Let's ride hard to Tumbleweed.
Let's go.
See, this is what happens when the Federals interfere in our affairs. Are you happy now?
No, I ain't happy at all. And I already told you, I ain't with the government.
Now you say that, John, but the only thing I know for sure is who sent you.
They made me come here. They gave me no choice. That's your federal permit, Mr. Johnson.
They come down here dressed as cocky as the King of Diamonds, talking a lot of flannel about helping us, about spreading peace and civilization to the West, but they brought nothing but trouble and taxes.
I agree with you. Wolves in sheep clothing, all of them, rob you and make you pay to have someone investigate the crime on your behalf.
People around here have been fooled into feeling protected when they're worse off than they were before.
The fellas I know don't care about people. All they care about is lining their pockets. Why is this sorry son of a bitch so important to them?
Norman Deeks, Williamson's right-hand man. In other words, a glorified errand boy.
You wait, Marshal! I'll be back for you!
Bill's standards have slipped.
We already filled you with lead once, you ugly
Deeks
bastard!
The kind of man who's mean enough to be second in command, but too cowardly and stupid to ever be a leader.
Don't ever use that line near your deputies. You know, for his sake, they'd best not have laid a finger on Miss McFarland. What is this place we're headed?
Tumbleweed? A lonely, godforsaken place. Some people say it's haunted. It was quite a town back in its day. Then they built the railroad to Armadillo and went clean past Tumbleweed. And that was that. Pretty soon, everybody had up and left. Now it's just thieves, smugglers, and bandits. Scum like Deke here. Oh, popular spot for lynchings, too.
Let's try to avoid that if we can, Marshal.
I just hope you're not taking advantage of the McFarlands, Marston.
They saved my life. Gave me food and bed when they had no idea who I was. I owe them more than I can ever repay.
That's just they've been through a lot. Well, they're both vulnerable, different ways.
I wouldn't have been running in and out of a burning barn to save their horses otherwise.
I know you helped. Just like you helped me. But you got your reasons for doing it.
It's no secret why I'm here, Marshal. I told you the very first time I walked into your office.
I trust you. It's just all this business with Blackwater and Williamson and the past. I don't know. Sometimes it's hard not to have doubts.
I understand. I never planned to be in the lawman business neither.
How is this mess supposed to turn out? Sending an outlaw to do the work of a lawman. That's madness.
Ain't much difference between the two, as far as I can tell.
There have to be rules, Marston. Even you must understand that.
It's easy to make up rules, but they ain't much use if people don't understand why. Like my son. If I tell him not to do something, he'll do it anyway, just to spite me. If I punish him, he resents me for it. But if I show him why it's wrong, at least he has reason not to do it again.
That's nonsense. Without laws, we're nothing more than animals. You look at Deke here. Man has worked hard at civilization. Your boy steps out of line, you whack him. He does it again, whack him harder.
You're a good man, Marshal.
And I respect what you're trying to do. But from what I've seen since I've arrived here, the law ain't really working.
Criminals are like weeds, Marston. Quick as you stomp one out, another one sprouts up in its place.
The boys will be getting ass poking, I bet. I can't wait for you to meet the boy.
Across the bridge!
Easy there.
John, you'll be exchanging the prisoner for Bonnie in the middle of town. Keep your eyes open. I sincerely doubt these scum plan to play fair.
Fair my ass.
You bet. Besides, Norm here is going to be my shield, ain't you, Norm?
It'd be my pleasure.
Marst. Sneak into town. Make sure you keep a gun on that son of a bitch.
I'm sure it's been nice for the boys to have a whore to play with. I hear those rancher girls like it in the rear. Get these ropes off of me, boys!
Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals with the law.
Come on! I've seen tougher nursemaids!
Quick! Bonnie!
Look out, boys!
Damn you! This way! Christ alive!
He directly found me!
Find Bonnie!
Bonnie! We're coming!
Take your skirt off! Let's do it!
You shoot like women! Don't think you'll be wanting this no more, friend. Where's Bonnie, you sons of bitches? Bonnie! Where are you? You give out lost. I won't let you die, Bonnie! Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals with the law.
Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals with the law.
You got a problem with me!
Find some cover, boys! What? Hey, John, you gotta get the body before they kill us.
You're gonna be hurt!
Let her go, or I'll kill every last one of you! Partner! Touch her again and you're all dead!
Got us a snake in the Willis.
You got it. Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals with the law.
Sons of bitches!
We're done for!
Stop doing that!
Look, over there!
I'd stay right there if I was you! Bonnie! Where are you? Where is she, you bastards?
What's out of there? You got a case?
She ain't involved in this!
Oh, there sure are a few of these fools.
Leave her alone!
Watch your hind parts, fella! Dirty cow!
Look, they're all running away. Now hurry up and free Bonnie. Come on, get her down.
You with me?
Come on.
Bonnie, are you okay?
I'm fine now, Mr. Marston. Thank you. Thank you. What the hell took you so long, you stupid man?
Well, you weren't exactly helping me.
If you think I'm gonna lower myself by making a joke about being all tied up, you got another thing coming. Come on.
Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. Wes Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy. Your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull. Feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America... That lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon. Extra hands. And I need some danger money.
So let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? Oh, no, the sport of kings. Racing, my friend, the sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating degenerate like myself can prosper. But come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive.
Now, sir, you get to reach.
Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?
I wouldn't say interesting, more deeply disturbed. I can see why you two get along.
I see the good in everybody, John. It's a flaw of mine. I have a soft spot for life's flotsam and jetsam.
Connection with it, more like. You and Seth have a lot in common. You both rob people, for one. Mind you, at least he waits until they're dead.
Oh, my dear boy. Nobody is more critical of drinkers than a drunk who's mended his ways.
What are you talking about?
Come on now, John. I've heard about you. You spent your life robbing people. It's a little inappropriate to be taking the moral high ground now.
I had the courtesy to put a gun in their face.
Whatever helps you sleep easily at night.
We stole from those who had too much. We tried to give to those who had too little.
A Robin Hood with spurs. Oh, romantic. You expect me to believe that poppycock? Maybe I'll have the good fortune to be able to leave my nefarious life behind one day and work on the government's dime.
Don't talk about things you don't understand.
Dear, oh dear, simmer down, my boy. You need to start appreciating your friends more. Folks around here don't see you as any different from Bill Williamson.
I didn't think I'd have to huckster snake oil and dig up the dead, that's all.
Take it from me, John. Collaboration is the key to success. I can help you. Seth can help you. It's business. Nothing more, nothing less. There's no need to make it quite so personal.
Suits me.
Talk about the race.
Yes, the race.
Oh, come on. Time to purge
ditch that negativity and start thinking like a winner. You're going to have a whale of a time. They've been holding these chariot races in New Austin as long as I can remember. And we need the money.
Why aren't you racing then?
Me? Oh, no. Not my thing at all. You have already proved yourself more than adept at the reins, my dear boy, and under some stress. These races are Byzantine in their ferocity, and the terrain is treacherous. People will do just about anything to win. Men die. It's a marvelous spectator sport.
Sounds like fun.
And you are my wild card, John. They won't be expecting you.
So what's your role in all this?
Think of me as your spiritual guide.
Do I have to?
You are a free man, of course. But I strongly recommend it. Imagine, just for today, you are not an aging bounty hunter, and I am not an avant-garde business pioneer. No, sir. Today, we are gladiators. Motivation, dear boy.
I'm definitely feeling motivated to get the hell out of here.
Thank you. Thanks, mister. I'll take care of this cart for Mr. Wes Dickens.
Come on, John. I suggest we beat a hasty retreat. Right. Best remove ourselves from the stage before somebody decides they want their money back.
Fine by me.
Isn't that fantastic? The cheers of the crowd, the thunder of the wheels.
The falling rocks, the homicidal maniacs.
Oh, come on, John. Even a cold-hearted misanthrope like you must have found that just the tiniest bit exhilarating.
Not the friendliest bunch, are they?
They take the racing very seriously in these parts. And your participation was not entirely free of food.
That was clear.
Ah, sport, war, and heartache. The guilty pleasures of mankind since the dawn of time.
I'd get away from the men we just swindled before you start waxing too lyrical.
Yes, yes, of course.
Well done, sir. Well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
Bitches, have y'all lost your damn mind? What? Mister, these fellas robbed a bank in Armadillo. I've been tracking them ever since. I'm a bit outnumbered. Would you mind lending your guns? Follow me this way! Yeah!
Don't make me shoot you, pal.
Thank you. Thanks for your help, mister. Now I trust you'll return this safe to the banker in Armadillo.
Sorry, ma'am. I'm a married man.
Yes, boyo. You messed up properly this time, didn't you? You little paddy bastard. You thieving Nick cunt.
You got it all wrong, Welsh. All wrong. It was French, I promise. He said he was going to rip you off. Now he's ripping me off.
Yeah, keep on talking there, Irish. In about 15 more seconds, your whole world's gonna turn black.
What's up, boys?
Fuck off, boyo. This don't concern you.
When a man with a sing-song voice tells me to fuck off, it always concerns me, boyo.
Look here. This petty bastard stole our guns. Tried to steal our horses. Law's clear on the matter.
I never stole nothing, sir. Never did. Not in all my life. That French cunt is playing with the Welshman's tiny and ineffective mind.
Hush your mind.
Anyway, y'all got horses now. No one needs to die. Leave them be.
Who do you think you are, boyo? The bloody cavalry?
Your voice is really starting to get on my nerves, boyo.
And you're getting on my nerves.
Yeah. You reckon that fool Irish is worth that?
That son of a... I always did have the last laugh, Welsh, my boy.
Mr. Nigel West Dickens said you'd help me locate a machine gun. And since I just saved your life...
Oh, I can't thank you enough for taking care of those two degenerates. Untrustworthy, poor in personal hygiene, lacking in the finer qualities of a gentleman.
What about the gun?
It'd be my pleasure. She's magnificent government issue. It'll be a bit of a ride, but we'll get there soon enough. Follow me, fella. Let's get this over with. The saloon's calling me.
too far to walk. Mount up, fella. This is turning into a hell of a day. What's your name, friend?
John. John Marston.
Choke of luck, you came along, fella. I thought I'd drunk me last breakfast there for a second.
Who were those fine specimens of humanity?
They was the only friends in the world. And boy, am I glad to see them bastards dead. We all met on the boat over a few years back, we did. Thick as thieves ever since, and that right there was the problem.
Is it normal for friends in Europe to drown each other?
Never trust a Welshman, me pa always told me. And he got his throat slit, so he should know. The kind of fellas who will steal an acorn from a blind sow and then kick her for squealing. And as for that French bastard...
He didn't sound very French. Easy.
Not far now. The Teban bastards are holed up at the cabin by the lake. Can't wait to see the look on their faces when we blast in there. They'll be more surprised than a slut dog with their first porcupine.
You best not be lying to me.
Listen, fella, I didn't ask for your help back there. I don't owe you nothing.
I'll decide what you do and don't owe me.
I've had enough of your overly aggressive manner, fella. You don't know who you're dealing with here.
Irish, I've met enough men like you to last me a lifetime.
You can make quick work of those fellas if they give you trouble. The gun's stored just inside that shack.
What about you helping me out?
I'll cover you from the ridge. I'm better from long range. It'll be a piece of cake, fella. Trust me.
Now this is getting ugly.
Back off now before I... We got ourselves!
Come on, then! We're gonna have to try harder.
I'm gonna kill you!
That one almost got me! You really want to die?
I done raised you there, sneaky deacon. Joseph and his brother. That poor heater can't burn no powder.
You're mine now, you dumb bastard! If it ain't me, it's someone else. Kiss my ass! It's not here. That lion sack of shit!
Howdy there.
Hey there. Hello there.
I hear that marshal pisses in a squat, if you catch my meaning.
I'll get a new horse next week.